हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस सम मोर मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन टॉपिक पुश्ड ऑन ऑटोमेटा। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ए पुश्ड ऑन ऑटोमेटा एम्प्लॉयज डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। विच डेटा स्ट्रक्चर इट यूज्ड? इट इज़ वेल नोन डैट इट यूज स्टैक दैट वर्क ऑन लिफो बेसिस लास्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट। basically this is used for to remember something. actually using finite automata we can't do anything like comparison, because comparison need to store data which is compared to coming data, but in the case of finite automata there is only one memory, that is input tape, which contain only current data which through which we cannot remember anything, but and there is also no facility about writing, there is no writing capability, but in case of and without writing capability you can't store anything. In the case of push down automata there is a stack type memory also used besides input tape, in which we can write anything which we have need in future. So stack type memory is used in push down automata. So the data structure that is used in push down automata is stack. Explanation is also here given. A push down automata uses stack to carry out its operation. They are more capable than the finite automata but less than the Turing machine. Oh, it is very good. The thing given here about capability, its capability lying between finite automata and Turing machine, and we can say that its capability is more than finite automata but less than Turing machine. Next question, state true or false. The operation of push down automata never work on element other than the top. It is true or false? Yes, it is true, because we know that push down automata use stack, and stack works on the basis of last in first out. So whatever we have pushed in at last will be popped at first. So the operation and the thing that is appear will be at the top of stack, which is popped or which is pushed. So the thing, the given, the operation of PDA never works on element other than the top. It's true. The term push down refers to the explanation given here. The term push down refers to the fact that the elements are pushed down in the stack, and as per the LIFO principle the operation is always performed on the top element of the stack. So we should remember that every time or in every move top of stack will be entertained. It will first popped and then the modifying value of the top of stack will be pushed into the stack. In every move it will be done. Which next question, which of the following allows stack values to be the sub stacks rather than just finite symbol? So it should be nested stack automata. Nested stack automata like a loop thing. Actually we know that nested means loop within loop, so it is just stack within stack means sub stacks type concept is given here. So which of the following allows stack value to be sub stacks rather than just finite symbols? So the answer C is correct. Nested stack automation. Explanation is also here given. In computational theory, a nested stack nested stack automata is a finite automata which makes use of stack containing data which can be additional stack. Next question, a non-deterministic two-way nested stack automata has n tuple definition. State the value of n. n is 10. A non-deterministic two-way. Two-way means the movement of the tap will be, the movement of head of tap will be in both direction, means from right to left and or right to left, left to right. So n tuple definition means here is given the value of n will be 10, and it is given here all the 10 tuple. First tuple is set of states, second tuple is input alphabet, third tuple 2 is stack symbols, delta is transient function, q0 is initial state, z0 is start symbol of stack, f is set of final state, and 2 square brackets left and right. So total number of and one more symbol is given here. So the number we can count 3 to 5 6 7 8 9 10 10 tuple total given here. So these are 10 tuple. Post down automata accepts which types of language? It is well known that push down automata accept context free language which is generated by context free grammar, that is CFG. And we know that CFG will have set of production rule, that is of type 2. So answer should be type 2, that is given in B option. Explanation: push down automata is for context free language and they are termed as type 2 language according to Chomsky hierarchy. Next question: the class of language not accepted by non-deterministic, non-erasing stack automata, non-deterministic and non, the class of language not accepted by non-deterministic, non-erasing stack automata. Stack automata means pushdown automata, because it use, if automata use stack, then it will be pushdown automata. And these all three all the mentions option is given here is correct. So D option is correct. N space or non-deterministic space is computational resource describing the memory space for a non-deterministic Turing machine. So the option is D is correct. And we know that it cannot recognize context sensitive language and any natural language. So all the option is given here is correct. A push down automata with only symbol allowed on the stack along with fixed symbol, which option will be correct? It is given counter automata. It is counter automata actually. Next question: which of the following are eligible in push down automata? Delete, insert, push, pop. Push and pop both are correct. Yes, so it is given A and D, and it is well known operation of stack. So push, pop, both A, D option both are correct. A string is accepted by PDA when stack is empty. Acceptance state both and B. So there is two different method for accepting the string by the PDA, that is empty store method and final state method. And here final state method is given in the form of acceptance state. So and the first option is stack is empty, so both option A and B is correct. And we know that in empty store method the bottom symbol, that is the start symbol of stack, also popped, so that whole stack is empty, nothing is there. And final state, and there is no need to be in final state method. So F, in case of whenever we are going to opt empty store method, then there is no set of final state, means we can say that set of final state is empty. And whenever we opt acceptance state method or final state method, then the bottom symbol of stack or start symbol of stack doesn't pop from the stack and there is need to be some final state in your PDA at which machine will be for accepting the string. Next question: the following move up PDA on the basis of what are the basis of PDA movement? Actually, we know that the transition function is given Q into input alphabet and into set of stack symbol. There are three bases on which we will decide the movement of the stack, movement of the PDA. So three things is to be necessary to decide the movement of the stack, that is present state, that is present and present input symbol from the tap and top of the stack. So but here is not given top of stack, so it is given here only present state and input symbol from the tap. So C option should be correct. A and B both are correct. If there is given top of stack, then that will be also necessary to be true. Next question, I will move to next page. Next page, first question is given: if two sets R and T has no elements in common, R is subset of T. I think it is not given in correct format. RCT is what, which type symbol is actually used is not clear. Then the set are called. Two sets R and T has no elements in common. RCT is equal to, then the set are called, actually this is not given in correct format. Actually it should be R intersection T is equal to phi. So this should be there. And according to that, it will be disjoint when two different sets have no common symbols. So both set are said to be disjoint set. So C option is correct. It is very simple question. It is at 6-7 earth standard question. But there is wrong thing is given about RCT. This thing is not given correct way. So you can interpret that whatever it is actually want to ask, that is about it is asking about disjoint. Which among the following is not a part of context free grammar tuple? End symbol, start symbol, variable, production. End symbol, there is no need of end symbol. Start variable is necessary, so it is given here as a start symbol, and variable is also necessary, and production is also necessary. All these three things given in BCD option are necessary in a pre-grammar, but there is no need of end symbol, so it should be A option, that is not a part of any grammar, not only context free grammar, not a part of any grammar. So A option is correct. Next question: a context-free grammar is a English grammar, regular grammar, context-sensitive grammar, none of the mentioned. Actually, it is not English grammar, it is not regular grammar, because regular grammar is more restricted. So context-free grammar is not to be necessary to be regular grammar. So B option also should not be correct. But any context-free grammar on need can be said context-sensitive grammar, so C should be correct. But what actually, yes, it is correct, because if you follow Chomsky hierarchy, then you can get easily that every phrase structure, every regular grammar on need can be said, cont CFG or CSG or PSG. In same way, every CFG on need can be said CSG and PSG. So context sensitive grammar option is correct. The closer property of context free grammar include concatenation, clean, union. I think it is union, all of the mentions, because closer property hold on every operation that is given here. It will work on clean as well as concatenation and also union. So all of the mentions are correct. It is very important question. It can be asked in your AKTU exam and also competitive exam. So this is important question. Which of the following automata takes stack? One more thing is important here. You should remember that it doesn't hold on intersection operation. Means if two CFL are given and if we do intersect operation, then it is not necessary to get as a result context free language and our context free grammar. And there is one more theorem that I have discussed already. Regular intersection closure, something like that name was, regular intersection context free grammar, something is given like that, because there is one language is regular and another is CFL. If then we intersect, then definitely we will get CFL. So you should remember that it does not work on intersection operation. When both languages are CFL, then you will not get CFL. Means it is not necessary actually. It may be or it may not, but it is not necessary actually. So whenever it hold on every pair of CFL, so we can say that it is closed on intersection operation. But if on some it works and on some does not work, then we can say that it is closed under intersection operation. But regular intersection CFL theorem, we know that if one language is regular and another is CFL and do intersection operation, then yield will be CFL. Next question, which of the following automata takes Q as an auxiliary storage? Which of the following automata, Q is not infinite automata, Poisson automata, so it is not infinite automata, actually only one type of memory, that is input tape and not any other, and that is actually Q memory, we can say. And in Poisson automata there is two types of memory, actually in finite automata there is only one type of memory, that is input tape. And in Poisson automata, tape and stack in Turing machine, we can use Q as an additional memory, additional storage. In finite automata, no additional storage. It have only mandatory one, that is tap. And Poisson automata it used auxiliary memory, that is stack. In Turing machine we can use auxiliary memory as Q, but every time it is in ordinary Turing machine it is also not, but we can use. So C option should be correct. A context free grammar can be recognized by Poisson automata, two way linear bounded automata. So both option is correct. So both A and B is correct. So C option is correct. Next question. A null production can be referred to as string, symbol, word, all of the mentions. String, it is given a string. So null production is always taken as a string in computational theory. Actually, null is also treated as a string which of its length is equal to zero. So that's why it is correct. Null is actually treated as a string of its length is equal to zero. So it is correct. In next question, the context-free grammar we generate a regular language is termed as regular grammar. Yes, it should be B option. Yes, it is given. NPDA stands for non-deterministic Poisson automata. Yes, it is correct. A option is correct. So all these 10 questions also important. So 20 questions I have already done in this video, and move to next page. Just take what is actually given here. The production of the form A is producing B, where A and B are non-terminals, is called unit production. It is very famous production rule, in which one non-terminal means variable is producing another variable, then it is known as null production, unit production. So B option is correct. And null production is like that, when one variable is producing null symbol or null string, then it is known as null production. So we have got two things, null production and unit production. Next question, halting states are two types. They are accept and reject, reject and allow, start and reject. No, it is accept and reject, means all on which state during machine actually halt. It may be actually notation, it may be actually information about a string is accepted or rejected. So accept and reject is correct answer. Third question, a push down automata can be represented as push down automata, null and FA plus stack. It is true or false? Yes, it may be true, because in a finite automata, whenever we used stack, it becomes push down automata. So A option is correct. It is given in pictorial form also. In next question, a push down automata can be defined as six tuple definition. 7 tuple definition, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what does the symbol Z0, start symbol of stack or initial stack symbol? So B option should be correct. D, which, what does the symbol Z0 represent? And yes, it is right, an element of G, because it is stack setup stack symbol, so it also part of G. So A option is correct also. Initial stack, no doubt, top stack alphabet. Yes, it may be top stack alphabet, because while we will start to acceptance of the any string, then the start symbol of stack will be as a top of stack. So that's why it is also correct. So D option means all the option given here is correct. Which of the following correctly recognize the symbol in context to PDA? Moves, transition function, or not moves. Yes, actually this is like that. It is not given in correct way. This is like that, like horizontal T. So moves option is given by moves is given by this symbol. So A option is correct, but not actually here given in correct form. So it should be actually like that. So little bit confused I also. Which among the following is true for the given statement? if there are string R and T in a language L, so that R is prefix and T and R is not equivalent to T, no DPDA can accept. If there are string R and T in language L, so that R is prefix of T and T and R is not equivalent to T, no DPDA can accept L by empty stack. Yes, first option is correct. No DPDA can accept L by empty stack. And all the explanation, necessary explanation is given here. Can refer it. Which of the following can be accepted by a DPDA? Palindrome, yes, it can be accepted, but so I have today discussed almost 25 to 26 questions, and all these are very important regarding to your AKTU exam. So please refer to this question and you can do more question on this website. Almost 1000 question is given here. Actually some unwanted click have been, so that is actually gone, so again I'm trying to open that page. We are doing push down automata. Actually we have done it first phase already. We have done yes, it have been done. It also have been done, I think. Yes, it have been done. And we are on third page actually. And I think question number 7. On this page, we are on question number 7. Which of the following can be accepted by a DPDA? So the set D option is given here, x to the power c. Actually it is concatenation of two string. First string is a arbitrarily can be taken, and second string is the complement of the first one. So this is correct answer. The A option, actually, why the language of palindrome over the alphabet cannot be accepted by finite automata. It needs some non-deterministic case. So which of the following for a counter automata with the symbol A and Z 0? The string on stack is always in the form a to the power n z 0. It is actually counter automata given, so B option is correct. Stay true, counter automata can exist for the language. It may be true, yes, it is true. And last question, grammar G. State which of the following is true. Language of all and only balanced string, and yes, it may be balanced because terminal every time generated is balanced, equal number of zeros and ones. ambiguous grammar, so all the options are correct. So today almost I have discussed 30 questions and try to do it. Thank you.